The fight against lawlessness in Gulu City is intensifying as the UPDF and police have joined forces to weed out wrong elements.
Those kids down there, sincerely speaking, others have been 18 and below. These kids are still manageable. But you find that if even their parents themselves are not minding. At the time we conducted the curfew, what were they doing on the streets? What were they doing in those corridors? You get me? Parents equally must come in when they come securing their children.
According to the 4th Infantry Division spokesperson, Kato Hassan, the street gangs can easily turn into organized criminals if not put in order early enough.
Any socio-economic transformation to occur in any region, there must be peace, there must be security, there must be a safe environment to give way for the development. Those kids you see here, they can easily be jeopardized and recruited into a bigger gang than what we see them today.
Walter Totika, a resident of Lukung in the city, applauds the security forces for intensifying their operations.
Actually, I'm so happy for what the security personnel they have done. The life in Gulu becoming very hard. You cannot walk alone in the night. And in some other areas, the bad spots. And I appeal to the security personnel to continue with this kind of operation.
While the Laro Peche Division head of LOC 1 chairperson says the gang leaders have not yet been detained.
If they have been lapped like this, they should be taken to court at least so that we can feast on this Christmas properly. Actually, to my own view that I see these boys, especially the most serious gangs were left out. And this crackdown has to continue. Out of this one which are arrested, the one we know thoroughly, they are left out. And I'm requesting this crackdown has to continue.
Fingerprints of the 147 suspects arrested last night have been documented, and if found guilty, will be produced in the courts of law.
Are involved in the motorcycle robberies. They are also involved in criminal activities of rape, bags and phones snatching at night, opium smoking, and some of them also, we have realized that at one point they had escaped from lawful custody. Yeah, and then there are also those ones who had previously evaded arrest from the security.
The Gulu City Resident Commissioner Odong Ping Dennis blames the rise of insecurity on unemployment, and he wants the parents to play their role in raising responsible citizens.
That made people to live in fear in Gulu City. So we decided to mount operations. We started last night and it is ongoing. And I think we have arrested quite a number of these youth known as Agu. And now security is busy sorting them out. Those who are found to have committed crime will be taken to court.
In the last 2 years, street gangs, local known as Agu, comprising of teenagers and young adults, have terrorized Gulu streets. Women have reportedly been raped, bags snatched, houses broken into, and in some cases, the LOC ones attacked. Reporting for the news, I am Joseph Omagor in the city.